So yeah, we're going to be carrying on with Lumina, following on from yesterday's stream. I think we've got about 4 or 5 puzzles left to do. This is the sound of the snake. Snake! Have at you, snake. Let's jump in, shall we? And continue. So I think we've got to do like all of this all over again. There's no save points on this, so... Alright, so... We was going on... This sort of thing, right? And think. Yeah, there's just a mirror in here. So, we was toying with the idea last off that we need to kind of place this one over here, weren't we? I think it's where we left off things yesterday. I mean, I think I was starting... I'll be honest, I was getting a bit frustrated with this last night. I don't know if I was just getting... tired or what it was, but... Okay, so... That's definitely a better way to do it than I did before, using that ledge... to, get up to there. Definitely. Okay. So we'll take that... So that's... Now we have 3 mirrors for this. So... Gonna want to do... Something like put this over here, right? Yes, we have this. Hopefully it's high enough. And then we have something like this, but we need to... We're in that there. It's like go for there on the rotation. Slowly, slowly, catch your monkey. Yeah, that mechanic's still quite something. Also, the reflection, no matter where you hit this, the reflection comes like straight out the middle, which is a bit bizarre. So we get a bit of a better angle on this, shall we? Seems a bit better angle. Have a bit more to work with this one now. There we go. Much better. I kind of feel as well that actually I should probably make sure that's like well up far enough like that. Because I think we have had instances so far where things have been a little too low and it's cost us. Am I in the light? I think I'm still in the light. Okay. So we should have this one. We can position over here. Because we need to... Oh. Oh, no. As I say, I was pretty sure I hadn't, like, missed one. So that's going to go to there. Then... I'm going to take this one to face... like there. Which will then allow us to... walk across here. And... of course, we can take the treasure. Okay, so I don't really know why I died there because I was, as far as I'm concerned, I was in the path of the light. So, I don't know if, like, walking backwards is... We talked about this last night, about walking backwards might be better. Okay. Walking backwards seems better, at least. It's just me, but the snakes seem to be getting, like, really, really loud. Alright, so what did I do here? Because I know I had both of the colours... I had both the colours, right? Yesterday. So... what did I do with this? Yeah, so that would have to stay open. So the only thing I can think is that I did... So my only thing I can think, right, is that I did this. Like, let's say to... there. I have to say this music is very, very, very reminiscent of Talos music. I don't even know where I'm pointing this right now. Obviously not there. One thing I wanted to check See, why are the snakes attacking me there? I don't understand why the snakes have got me there, because... I was, like, in the red and the green light, I think. I think the snake thing is not so good. Goodness, I know if you go too quickly. Alright, so I'd take that. So what I was wondering is, if I now go over here, I'm in the red light. Don't you dare. You see, it's things like this that I don't get, because why has that mirror moved? And why have the snakes just killed me? I'm in the light. I'm stood in the light. No? Alright, so I can't just... Okay. That's fine. We learnt. Of course, I reported this. I sent an email back to the devs today regarding that issue, because that whole knockback thing is really, pardon the pun, the knockback thing is really frustrating. So I don't know what causes it. That's the thing. I don't really know how to stop it. Alright, it stopped. Alright, so. Just want to get across here now, please. Alright, if I can just walk in a straight line. That would be ace. Hopefully that's going to put me in the middle, though. It does. All right. All right, so. So we have a blue. Which for now at least I can open up this. I'm a bit concerned about like the amount of mirrors and things we're currently getting. We are getting a lot. So I gotta go there. What's the play here, though? We have a red. So we need to do red and blue. Excuse me? Okay. Excuse me? Okay. So here then. I gotta do that. Okay. Okay. That moves us into here. And I guess we're going to do something like that. Again, though, I'm extremely worried about how complex this is getting. Oh, so I need to send both of them up here so that I can open that. Okay. Move it then. Okay. It's the sort of thing I want to do. Wait, can I see the... So I can't see that from there. So I've got to refract that here. Well, I don't know how that works. That's somehow activating the... The only thing I can think is that you've got some sort of... The developers have got some sort of like trigger here. Which is like activating so far in front of them. It does give me the idea though to do... I mean, that's completely broken now. But yeah, that's what I was kind of going for. I just think there's some like trigger issues there. Not that I know how Unreal Engine works or anything, but... Alright, of a weird area. I swear down right, that sound effect for that scorpion is somebody munching down on either an apple or a crisp or something. No joke. That's what it sounds like to me. Alright, let's check out over here. Get more mirrors. Excuse me. My lord. Oh, well, we made it to the end of the level. It was too late. We set our plan in motion. What was it too late for? Why did this... Why did sunlight appear all of a sudden, though? That was... a little bit strange. If I do say so myself. Take that. Right. Okay. Then we're done here. So I think I need to bring blue back through here. So I think I can go back through here. So if I refract the blue over to here. Plenty of mirrors, let's face it. All right, so what do I actually need for here? I need a blue, which is going to come through here. I need a light blue, which is probably going to come through here as well. And the purple I've got there. So I need to bring the light blue and the blue through here if I can. Light blue is green and blue. Okay. Do I need to take this back? Don't understand why I am being killed for that. Or that. I don't know, I just don't get some of these deaths.
Hit.
Alright, well, I've got the backwards walking glitch again. Now, I'm not sure I need that red anymore, but I'm not going to take it. I guess I could. Again, backwards walking glitch killed me. It seems like it's something to do with when you are looking in a certain direction. Or when you're interacting with a mirror or one of the hieroglyphics walls. And it seems like when you like unfocus from that, it just kicks in. I can't say for sure. Over one. Okay. So green and blue. Okay. Oh, I'm going to keep that there. Where I need another blue? So this is the issue, right? I need more blues. Don't I? Do I get a ton of that each time I do that, maybe? Oh. All right, well. We forgot about this one, I guess. A group of us killed Ka-Nefer and trapped him, his soul, in his treasure. Q walking bug. So that was only mirrors, though, right? To be honest, didn't really help me. Do I need to open this up? that would make sense. But how do I keep a... Alright, so that would make sense, but... Honestly, I don't know how I would keep that out here. You know what, right? I got so many mirrors here. I don't really know what I'm doing anymore. If I could take that through to there, what did I need the green for? The light blue. If I could take the light blue through, I don't need the green. I left the mirror at the top as well, which is not ideal. Have I not got the right things here, though? Already set up? No, because I need to... That's right. I think I need to move this one. I'm not even sure. I'm so confused how any of this is working. Okay. Okay, so excuse me. This is now a thing we have. I don't know how to get this other one through here. So I need to go through there to get that other one back. Do The red light's not doing anything. So, as well as just take the extra mirror, right? Not sure how that's working, but okay. It's green and blue that make the light blue. That's not good. That's not good at all. I'm trapped. Alright, not trapped. So what, the beam of light physically stops the other beam of light? I'm not sure that that's how light works, really, but okay. I don't know. It's got to be blue and green, but I just genuinely don't know how to... Thank you. Now, I hope this is not a thing. Well, thank goodness that's not a thing. So I can't put the green through here. I genuinely don't know. I'm just always one colour short, because if I was to bring the light blue through with enough mirrors, then I then wouldn't have the blue, because I would need to do I'm also gonna make white. Like, genuinely, at this point, I don't know. Then am I just missing something? Like with that other puzzle though, am I just missing something really simple? Hmm. What's going on, Aaron? How are you this fine Friday evening? I mean, the only thing I can think to do at the moment is to undo this whole thing. And I've got 8 mirrors. Like a stupid amount of mirrors. Yes. It's got a lot of similarities to Talos, Chromagun, Rethink. Lots of puzzle games. At this point, I'm just not sure what I'm meant to be doing. If I'm completely honest. But yeah, other than that, man, I'm doing pretty well. The weekend, which is always a positive. Okay, so then that's no longer open. Yeah, that's a thing. I don't get it. I'm one colour short, and I don't know where to make or to get this other colour from. Not unless now you want me to go all the way back to the beginning. These snakes, man. I'm wondering now I've got all this, do you want me to go back to the beginning and bring both the green light and the blue light over here? Don't say I gotta do all this again. That would be pretty sucky. Not gonna lie. Yeah, I bet you want me to do that, don't you? I bet you want me to do that, don't you? So I need to replace this prism with a mirror. Hey. So now I have... Now I can just walk the line. That's fine. I don't care about dying anymore. Because now... what do I think of this? If I'm honest, I don't think it's great. I'm finding a lot of issues with it. Oh, but I can't do that because of... So that was a waste of time because... Sorry, Aaron, I didn't mean to cut off what I was saying there. I will answer your question in a minute. But I'm gonna need... To do that... right, this is a big issue right here, look. No hands. And my character just wants to walk on its own. Just one of the many things about this game. So, I can take the prism with me though, right? Okay, so I can take the prism. That's something at least. That's not the thing I wanted to do. But yeah, there's just loads of like little... There's loads of finicky bits with this errand, and like for instance, we've got this like snake mechanic here. So the idea behind the snakes is that you have to, while you're walking, with the light on you, the snakes won't get you, but it doesn't always work like that, which is. Tad frustrating. Much like the rotation controls are a little bit weird. Well, I did last night in 3 hours. I did 13. And for the last hour and a bit, I've been trying to work out this one. So yeah, that kind of gives you an insight, right? As to this level. I feel like the difficulty curve, though, has not been constant in the game, either. You start off, like, relatively easy. And then it goes kind of ridiculously hard for a bit. Yeah, it's not too bad on the frames per second side of things. It's using, it's Unreal Engine is the engine that they are using. Did that open that other door? It's just little things like this where these snakes are just, I don't know. it was a cool gimmick, but it's also a very annoying gimmick once it's been used once or twice. It doesn't really add to the fact that I don't really feel like it adds any sort of like puzzle-y element to it, so to speak. It's not like, okay, how do I need to get around it? It's literally just, okay, I'm going to point a laser over it and I just walk across. Once you've done it once, there's no real challenge to getting across there. So I just don't know what to do. I honestly don't know what to do anymore. Because I need a blue, okay? I need an extra blue, because I need to use the blue and the green to I haven't decided yet. It depends how I feel once I finish playing this errand, to be fair. So the only thing, right, that I can think I need to do here to be fair, I wasn't expecting to kind of like still be on this after an hour of streaming this level, so right, I think, and if this is right, it's going to be a bit of a pain, but I think I've got to work my way all the way back, almost. The picture of the map. Okay, so don't need. Just the controls on some of these are like really weird. The way you rotate the stuff. Do you know what? I think I've been a complete and utter. I've worked it out and it's. Which I think I've worked it out. Oh my god, I can't believe this. So, turns out this was actually a hell of a lot simpler than I was making it. Right, can I get more of an angle on this? Little things like this, though, that really I don't like. Can I get around this? No, that's the problem. Can I actually angle that in? So I need that there, I need that there. So I need a mirror to reflect. Alright, so I don't need any of this stuff here. I can take that one. This one's just going to go and point over to there, like that. Man, I massively overcomplicate this. So, here's my issue with this, though. What's the prisms for? Because... pretty sure... I ain't used the prisms. The controls are actually quite interesting, shall we say? We've finally done it. Man. So what are the prisms for? Did we use the prisms? I don't think we did. I feel like the problem with that level, however, was... The reason it was difficult was because it was so big. I feel like that was... I don't know the look of that. I feel like the level was just far too big. And I feel like difficulty was added there through the complexity of the puzzle. But, it's just my thoughts. We're small and blind trying to survive while the abyss calls. Alright. So I need... those who set us free died in unusual conditions shortly after. Right, I have a hunch that... It's basically about the story. The gist of the story is about this king called, I think the king's called Ka-Nefer, and it's all about how he was trapped in here, and the architects changed the plans to trap him. If I'm honest, I don't think I'm. I don't feel like I'm overly invested in the story, unfortunately. So I need to go, I'm guessing that's green on top. There's just like really little things. Like, they came up with this idea, they've got this mechanic where you can, rather than having to like point the laser, you can actually look, you can press space. So I'll place this here, for instance. And then you press space, look at the beam. But it kind of rotates in your position. So sometimes when you're kind of like around things, you have to like come off it, find yourself a position where you can actually see something, then do it, and then look at the beam. It's just really weird. Rather than sort of like snapping to what I would assume would be kind of like the reflection point, so like the center of the mirror. I don't know, it just kind of seems to do weird things like that. Any treasure for me to take? I guess not. So I guess I'm gonna put something to there. So let's swap these mirrors around now. Get this one from here. See what I mean? Like it's like when you do the look at beam end, it's not central on the beam. It's like taking my center point rather than the mirror center point. So you have to click off, reposition yourself, and then press it again while you're in a better position. I just feel like that would work better if it was centered on the point of the beam and not the player. But hey ho. Come on, the treasure. Give me the treasure. This pyramid must never be found. Rip. I just got a red laser there. I assume I'm going to need the green laser to open that door. Just an assumption, though. All right, so that needs to... So I have that. That one needs to point to... I think that points straight to this, and that'll probably point up straight up to there to give me the green light. Then I can go back up to the upper area. I'm no expert with light and mirrors, but I should go straight up, right? Oh, that's blue, it's not green. Rip. Ripperoonie.
Ripperoonie!
Oh, just give me 2 seconds, Scott. Just do some laundry. 2 seconds.
Thank you.
All right, guys, Mac. Apologies for that. We can do laundry at like this time of night. Jeez. What has the world come to? All right. It's just a red light. I guess the green one opens this. So, can I get a light up into here? I guess is the question, right? Not only that, but to do. Can't see a thing. So I did this. Go and get that other mirror. So I can point that to there. What do we see behind the blue door? Maybe that's something we need. Maybe that'll be helpful. I've been a couple of times so far during the game that I've struggled because I've not seen items. Because they've been hidden. Game, that is blue. Had that on the last puzzle as well, briefly. That's another mirror. Okay. I'm getting the idea here. Take that one. Take this one. I'm going to take the green one all the way around here. Yep. Okay. Get past here, please. Thank you. to be lower. Something opened. Excuse me? Oh shit. Boys, we're screwed. Is he coming? Guys, we got a breakout. Code red. I don't know what I'm meant to do here. I guess we just do this right, but where is he? The guy's here somewhere. Where's that mummy at? Up to this point, Aaron, no, there hasn't been. But that mummy just broke out, and I don't know where he's gone. Which is slightly worrying. Thank you. I'm trying to like take this down here. This one. Oh boy, we're dead. Okay. Okay. What's this? 16 out of 18. There are things our minds are not able to comprehend. Possibly like what just happened there. The translate thing, I think, is a bit... It was a cool thing the first time, but then after that, I kind of feel like it should just do like a quick animation and just like show the text. Deep under lies a gate for the things that lurk in the darkness between the stars. It's all about like, is that like a metaphor for talking about hell? So, like the gates of hell for things that lurk in the darkness between stars, i.e. like creepy crawlies and dead things roam around at night time. Is that what that's insinuating? Oh my god. Things getting spooks. Things getting spooks. Things are getting spooky. This is inside a pyramid. Okay. Maybe come back for that. Got a red over there. I just guess we gotta do purple first. We don't seem to have a lot of other options at the moment. Still though, I kind of wanted to go. I can't though using more than one. I was hoping I could kind of like go inside there. It's like right now the controls are backwards. They are literally backwards. Really difficult to control. Where did that open? Okay, so I opened that and it gives me a light all the way across to that side. Have I just messed things up though? I'm not sure I can get back. Not sure I can get back. Oh, I can. Because I've got, okay, because I got this to the mirror. And it's like this. Take that one away. Take that one away. There we go. Excuse me, I don't know if I need this one though. I do, because I still need to hit this one. Okay. Okay, that gives me the blue one. What's that one over there? That was green. Okay. Oh man, let me in that treasure room. I want me some of that treasure. Sivu play. Okay, so I get another one here. I guess I could. So I could do that, but then I'm trapped in here. Not sure where I go from here, though. So that does that, that does that. Now, do I need this anymore, or can I just take everything up now? Let's go for the let's take everything up approach. Treasure. So I'm yet to see a green light. What color do I need for here? Okay, so I'm gonna set all that up again. It's my own fault. Green light's over there, by the looks of it. So let's go to there. And we put one here. And the blue one we point over to the other side. Because that's a light blue window. So that'll give us the light blue to open up the door on this side. Door open. I quite like the look of these big open areas, but one thing that's really annoying is the constant back and forth. I've also realised I'm really bad with mirrors and reflections. Like, seriously bad. Let me see where I'm aiming. Do you know what? I could also try and come through here. That could work. Treasures and light will be our downfall. I'm stuck. God, look at all these mirrors. I've now got 6 mirrors. Pretty insane. Might need to be a bit higher. Although we're going down, so maybe not. Okay. Oh, good God. So here's my feeling on this right now. I feel like the game is punishing me as a player for experimenting with different things and trying bits and pieces, because at the minute I'm just sort of trying to find my feet and find a way to get things in positions, but every time I kind of make one little move, the game's kind of like, well, you did that wrong, now you gotta go and set everything else up again. So yeah, I kind of feel the game is punishing me for experimenting and trying things, which not particularly great puzzle design, I have to say. I mean, I've got, like, a mass of mirrors here. I can just plan everything out. I'm certainly better with right angles than... trying, like, ridiculously stupid angles. What have I got here? These rooms are pretty epic, though. I do like some of these rooms. Amanura's light keeps them at bay. Keeps what at bay? Please tell me you're not talking about the snakes again. Because I feel that would be pretty pointless. So how many more mirrors are you going to give me? Jeez. So I need a white light as well. So I'll be honest, my current problem, what I don't understand how to do, is get back into this room over here. And I feel like maybe... Alright, Aaron, no worries, buddy. Have a good weekend. I'll catch up with you next week. I kind of feel like, because I didn't do that there... the first time, it's kind of now punishing me for... this different way. Well, that's a blue light. So I need... so I need to point my green over to here. I think. But... to do that... I need to take this away so I can get back up to all the way over to here. This bit just sucks, doing this bit over and over again. The game would benefit so much from, like, okay, you've done this once, so here's a way that you can, here's like a shortcut, so you don't have to do this bit again. The game would benefit so much from that. Thank you. can't jump down there. But I can jump down there when it's higher. I guess you stop people jumping down there, though, too, so that people like, can't fall off the geometry, so... Doesn't even create that. Gives me a white light, but white light, no good. Well, I have to say I'm feeling pretty deflated at the moment. I think because of like what happened in the beginning that I like really struggled, and we seemed to like make a massive hash of things almost. It's kind of put me in a bit of a, I don't know, unfocused mood, I guess I could probably call it. I just feel unfocused right now, so I think good progress has been made, and we should probably think about calling it a night for tonight, and we can certainly pick it back up again. On Monday. When I'll be back to streaming. Monday, of course, will be Tuesday for anybody watching on YouTube. I just wanted to check this before I do call it a day, just to see what I actually needed to get back into here. Yeah, so that's just putting like blue through. Is that even blue? I think it might be. Is it blue? It's really hard to tell. You can't really see very well from like down here, but I think it might be. I just wanted to see whether or not it was green. I think it might be green. No, it's the light blue. So light blue is a combination of blue and green. But you know, how do we hit that? Is the next question. I don't know. I'm pretty beat, pretty deflated right now. So I think rather than pressing on and getting more frustrated with myself tonight, I think it's probably a good place to stop. Thank you everybody for tuning in. I appreciate the support. The stream will be back on Monday night. So that will be a new episode on YouTube on Tuesday. So we've got this and two more levels left to play. Things are getting spooky. Definitely. We've got some things just roaming around now. Whether or not we're going to actually get attacked, I don't know. Well, I'll have to wait and see. With regards to the game, I think there's still some things that really need ironing out. So the two main things, I mean, I've already reported back to the developers that there's the thing that makes you run and move on your own. The other thing, bug wise, which is quite a big bug, is that sometimes the doors will stay open, or they will open on a single color, or you're not even aiming anywhere near the sensors and they will go off. So I don't know if that's a hitbox thing that maybe needs tightening up perhaps. And thirdly, and I know this is not an easy thing to implement being so far down the road in development, and you know, the game's coming out on Wednesday coming, so in 5 days time, but definitely shortcuts. You know, I always feel with puzzle games, it's you punish the player for trying something. So once they've done something once, why make them do it over and over and over again? It makes absolutely no sense, and it would be a really good thing if there was just some way that's okay, so you've done that. It's like here, for instance. Okay, you've done this, so this door opens up here. There's a door here that opens, and then you no longer have to keep setting this up. Because doing this every time, right? Coming here, setting a laser up here. Laser to there. That's fine. Then you gotta pick this one up. Then you gotta take this one away. And then you've gotta find the right position to curiously place that laser back to where it needs to be to point to there to activate everything else. I mean, it'd be so easy if there was just a little door here. Okay, I've done this once, that opens up so I can just walk back through here. I don't have to repeat myself again. You know, little things like that make a big difference with game development and the player's experience. And I feel I would feel a lot better if there was more of that sort of stuff in here, and it would make me feel like I wasn't just doing the same thing repeated over and over again. But like I say, I know that's not something that can be fixed quickly, because that would mean whole geometry changes and everything. But it's definitely something I would consider. Definitely something I would consider implementing. But yeah, we need to get in there. Anyway, guys, like I said, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully, if the developers are watching this, they can take some constructive criticism back. So they're the three main points. The snakes are still, or were still, a massive issue for me. I don't quite understand why we need the snakes to work in the way they do, because even when you're in the light, sometimes you get hit by the snakes, so it's just more of a frustration for the player. Because they're not doing anything wrong and they're walking in the light, yet the snakes can still kill them somehow. All little things like that, but I guess they all come with time. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate the support. We're back next week. Enjoy your weekend. I've been Nock. You will soon.
See ya.